I'm here with Zab Judah, one of the best fighters, five-time world champion.
We out here, you know, MGM.
What's next for Zab Judah?
Right now, you know, just training right now. I'm staying focused, watching the calendars, watching everybody, you know what I'm saying? So everybody out there know I'm watching you. 147, 140, I'm watching you.
147, a lot of big fights. 140, a lot of big fights.
Yeah.
Who would you want? If Zab could line up three fights, anybody on the planet?
I mean, I don't know. I think I'm, you know, I let the fans do the pick. I think I'm a little, you know, I've been in the game a little too long to be, you know, saying, reaching back, calling out these guys. I ain't got no time for that. But if a situation should present itself and it's come right and it looks great to me and my team, yeah, we're going to be coming at you.
There's talk of Broner versus John Molina Jr. at 140. What do you think of that fight? Adrian Broner, John Molina Jr.
It's a good fight, you know. Molina Jr. is a good fighter, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, Broner's hungry right now, you know what I'm saying? He's going to come back. I know how it is to lose a fight and to come back, you know what I'm saying? You got desperation and hunger in your heart, especially when you know you ain't no loser like that, you know what I mean? So I know Broner's next fight, he's going to be excited.
If Amir Khan fights Broner, what do you think of that fight?
A good fight, you know. Amir has good boxing ability, you know what I'm saying? Broner has great boxing ability. It's gonna be a good fight.
Zab, what advice do you have for young fighters who want to accomplish not everything that you do, because not a lot of people can do five-time champ, but just want to win one championship? What does it take?
Hard work and dedication, man. You gotta work hard. You gotta dedicate yourself. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta just try to achieve what people think you can achieve. You know what I'm saying? Was just doing stuff that people thought that I couldn't do. I was a little guy my whole life, you know what I'm saying? I'm still a little guy, you know what I'm saying? So when I went into certain fights, they said, oh, that little guy can't do nothing. And I proved that my speed, my boxing ability, my power, it kept me still here, you know what I'm saying? 18 years later, I'm still here, baby.
Every time I interview you, someone tells me, why didn't you ask Zab about the rap business? Because he was in there with some of the biggest rappers.
Yeah.
Who were some of the rappers that everybody's asking me to ask you about?
As what?
Like you worked with, collaborated with a long time ago.
I used to have my boxing music label, Super Cartel Records, back in the days. I mean, now, right now, I got little James right now. He's the project right now. He's number one. Ain't nobody touching him. 17-year-old monster from Minnesota. Watch this. It's gonna be crazy.
He has bars.
Little James. Who is Little James? Remember that. Who is Little James?
Brandon Rios.
I know, it's my boy.
What is it all that? Come on, fire, buddy. You see?
Okay, so really quick, we're here. What's your best memory from right here fighting in Vegas?
A lot. I mean, I got memorable moments. Casa Zoo moments, Mayweather moments. I got, tons of them. I got some great moments here.
And we thank you for those moments.
But one thing I do say is, y'all can't front. I put on some exciting brawls, man. You know, when it don't go our way, we turn up.
There you have it, Zab Judah, one of the best. Peace to report.com and Malisa back reporting. Thanks, Zab.